the administration.
Board of benches, aren't they?
Well, not always, I think, I don't know.
Can we call?
Go ahead.
Can we dedicate the new park that's going in under her name, call it the Debbie Mintz Park, or Mintz Park?
If we're gonna, you know, I know Debbie, and I've worked with Debbie, and participated in the Fleet of Flowers for many years. In one hand, if we're gonna thank Debbie, which thank you, Debbie, we are doing that tonight. I think Tanya York should be recognized, because she carried it for many, many moons before that. And so, I just, not that I don't wanna see Debbie get recognized, but if we recognize Debbie in something like we all say, which I have no problem with, we should do the same for Tanya, because she spent 15 years running that event, and I don't want her to diminish that contribution in itself.
Maybe a wall of honor is a good thing, because, you know, we can put more than one person up there, and for different.
So, interesting question.
Okay, I have a thought then. We've started developing some pocket parks around the city. What about the idea of taking one of these and making it into the Fleet of Flowers Memorial Park, and having a monument or a stone or something dedicated to all of the selfless volunteers who've given their time, their energy, and their hearts to, you know, to keep the Fleet of Flowers.
Yeah, they like that better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The whole bench thing, though, just that's a memorial thing.
Well, you do have a point about that, but yeah.
Robert, but there again, I agree that if you call it the Depoe Bay or Fleet of Flowers Memorial.
Oh, that's.
You're saying the Fleet of Flowers is completely dead.
Oh, okay, well, we could modify that.
Well.
Good point.
Mr. Mayor?
Yeah.
I don't think it's too far off to call it that, because it's all about Memorial Day. It's the Fleet of Flowers Memorial Park. I think that there's a certain name association and description there.
Well, I could just use, how about the word dedication? Dedication park.
Oh, sure, that sounds good for that.
Well, how about our newest park? We got a pocket park. We got a pocket park overlooking the ocean and the bay.
Yeah. Can't think of any place that would be more appropriate.
It seems like it's me if we're gonna do something like that. Pat, is there precedent for this, Kirby, in the city's history?
No, but I was thinking that you have a very active and involved Parks Commission.
Yes, we do.
And maybe they would like to bounce this around. It's a great idea.
Thank you.
Well, can we do this? Can we write a letter to both her and Tanya saying thank you, and tell them what we're thinking about doing and explore that? Would that be an appropriate thank you for now, Mr. Mayor?
That's another good idea. In the meantime, we can turn it over to the
Parks
Commission.
So would we have to make it just for Fleet of Flowers, or could we make it some type of dedication park to where we can add other people, maybe Harbor Commission people, maybe council, maybe mayors, maybe anybody that's volunteering at the time, that we can add those people where we're dedicating and recognizing everybody.
Recognition part.
Right. Recognition part.
Well, that would be another good one as well, because the memorial was put up for two fishermen who lost in the 30s.
Mm-hmm.
And every year, with the exception of one or two boats, all the boats in the harbor participate in this event as well. So we just kind of round it all together.
Recognition park.
Somehow.
I thought the dedication park.
The Parks Commission, perhaps.
Sounds better than Bradford Street Park.
Yes,
oh,
it is.
About that. Our engineers came up with that.
That's similar to New York. So, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion that. Then we go ahead and send both Debbie and Tanya York thank you letters for their years of service collectively. And that letter says that we're going to give it to the Parks Commission, and that the Parks Commission is going to decide how we're going to name our newest, latest, and greatest park.
Our newest what?
A park, the latest and greatest park, yeah. That's the inner motion, it's called Bradford's.
That to York and Metz as.
We're looking into it, we're gonna give it to the harbor, or we're gonna give it to the Parks Commission and have them kick it around, I think Perry's right, that's.
Need recognition of them.
Yeah, and the others that do service.
Yeah.
Get some home runs.
That sounds like a lot of mealy mouth there, you wanna repeat that back?
What I have is to send Debbie and Tanya thank you letters, that we're giving the matter to the Parks Commission to name our latest and greatest park.
Yeah.
And then I didn't want to name, but.
I ran out of steam.
You could just put in association with the Fleet of Flowers.
Yeah.
Or volunteer organization.
Volunteer organization.
Right.
Yeah, because otherwise, what I was thinking was that the two are totally separate, and unless you say what your thoughts are, they're gonna think, well, why are you telling me about, you know, you're saying that to me?
Right.
So.
I'll second.
If I could get a readback on it, I'll be able to vote.
Yeah, modify.
Have you got all that, Perry?
Okay, I'll try again, send Debbie and Tanya thank you letters, and in the letters, we would inform them that the matter is being given over to the Parks Commission to name our latest and greatest park. And then I've got in association with Fleet of Flowers, but that was changed to, I wrote down the word volunteerism, or volunteer.
Volunteer organizations.
And people.
Community service.
Community service, something like that. Just don't like the park bench thing, which is.
In any case, the fact that she's being recognized, and Tanya as well.
Yes.
Is something that really needed to be done.
Yes.
Yeah, now what's, who's gonna replace her?
That's a question for another day.
That's a tough one. Okay, we have a motion and a second.
Yep.
Call please.
Fisher Brown?
Yes.
Olson?
Yeah.
McElwain?
Yes.
Gambino?
Yes.
Grant?
Aye.
Teen?
Yes.
Item X, correspondence.
Three items of correspondence tonight. The first is a letter from the Confederated Tribes of Select Indian Tribal Council addressed inviting our mayor to the restoration celebration at the casino on November 14th. I spoke with the mayor, and I believe the only expense would be fuel to drive over to the casino.
Drive up there.
Headdress. He's not allowed to wear it. He's not drunk.
What?
You're not allowed to wear it.
They won't let you.
So.
I work there.
I know the chief.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he'll let me drive his headband.
Well, that's true, you probably would.
All right.
The second item is, we had applied for an Oregon Department of Transportation Small Cities Allotment Program grant to do overlay paving up on the North Point area, and we got the letter that our grant application was not approved, so.
Was it sexy enough?
That's sad.
So we'll try again next year.
You know, the guy that decided probably drove through Lincoln City there through all that money that ODOT's spending and then worked his way to Depoe Bay.
Yeah. Just eight.
What was it? Well, what monies were being spent. That's my theory.
Last item is an email from Kathy Wyatt. She is informing the council of a couple of opportunities to place ads in upcoming news times. She included the prices. First of all, they're going to have a special section in their November 11th edition honoring veterans in our community. She's wondering if the council might want to place an ad. There, you can get a 2x2 for $66 or a 3x5 for $132. And then she also mentions they're doing a full page in the paper to celebrate the Whale of a Christmas in Depoe Bay. It will run on the Friday, December 4th edition. And again, she's got a $66 ad, $99, and $132. So
She just wanted you to know that that's available, and if the council would like to place any of those ads or.
So one of them's for Veterans Day celebration, and the other one's for a whale of a Christmas here in Depoe Bay. Mm-hmm. We're gonna get. We have one of those.
Apparently. It's the whale of a Christmas in.
Is the tree gonna light this year?
That's part of my. We're getting into that. That's a segue. We're gonna segue.
So would the council like to do either of them?
I'd like to propose. I'd like to make a motion to approve an ad for veterans for the or at least the $66. I feel kind of cheap doing that, but I'll make it for. At least to have a presence in there for Depoe Bay.
What does that do? Does it say just basically Depoe Bay recognizes all veterans?
Yeah, something like that.
City of Depoe Bay.
She told me that at least one other city, they were doing something to honor their employees who are veterans. So it was specific to their employees, but it can just say something nice. You know, City of Depoe Bay honors our veterans.
I like that, so we're encompassing everybody into just our employees, because we have a lot more veterans than just the
PLC. Well, is it in congruence with Veterans Day?
November 11th.
Okay, yeah, let's do it.
I'll second Jerome's motion.
All right.
No, I just seconded his motion.
I would ask Mr. Grant to go big or go home, and let's just do a 3x5 ad and get some presents. And
if I
will.
Okay, then I will.
And it is.
So we'll go with the 3x5. This my motion is the second of amended, and I friendly with that.
Okay.
And you're the second.
All right, yeah, we're good. Cool.
Goal, please.
Olson.
Yeah.
Mathala.
Yes.
Gambino.
Yes.
Grant.
Aye.
Team.
Yes.
Fisher Brown.
Yes.
That's all the correspondence.
Joe's got something.
What about the Christmas?
Yeah, the whale.
You want to do the whale of a Christmas in Depot?
Oh, yeah.
And that, she says, will be in the December 4th newspaper. Got a 60, she doesn't have the size, but 66, 99, 132.
I bet you that's the correspondence, the same rate.
Yeah.
Is the chamber doing that? Like, are we going to be redundant?
Chamber runs out of them, right?
Yes.
Well, my thoughts on that are that I think that right now the chamber could probably use all the help it can get, especially from the city.
Yeah.
No negative reflections on any one of the wonderful people who are volunteering in the chamber or members. But, you know, one of the things that I've seen, in my tenure in retail in Depoe Bay for the last almost 7 years, is that we need to bring more people into the downtown area, both for shopping and for, you know, for the ideas of their holiday meals and catering as well. So I think that I would like to make a motion that we spend $132 and participate in the full page ad for the Whale of Christmas in Depoe Bay.
Go big or go
home. That's right.
And I'll second that motion.
Yeah, there's a discussion.
Yeah.
You know what? I have no problem with that. But I really think the chamber should be brought in on that. The chamber's run it for years. Let's tell them that we want to help advertise it. And let's not take that away from them. I think that would be as hurtful as it would be helpful not to communicate.
Yep.
So that's all.
Robert? I couldn't agree more, sir. Yeah.
Right.
Just simply as a matter of making sure we're not being redundant. You know, all of a sudden now here's Depoe Bay advertising.
And then they're doing something.
Chamber of Commerce on the next page.
Do we have time on that piece?
That one.
We have time on that.
I believe.
And
let's, as you said, get the chamber notified at least and or involved to let them write.
Well, that's kind of what I'm thinking. Yeah. I want to know if
I can modify my motion to
I'll withdraw my second if that's the case.
I was wondering maybe we just shouldn't have the civic staff contact the chamber, see if they're interested and if we want to work collaboratively on this and help fund. I'm not saying we shouldn't do it.
Maybe we should explore it a little first before we
can. I think we've got time on that, don't we? I'm almost sure we do.
Based on their normal lead time to submit something, I would guess we've got time before we send it.
Well, I'll withdraw the motion then in favor of having staff coordinate with the chamber.
Right. And then we'll just go for it.
Yeah,
I'll withdraw my second.
Okay. Maybe we could bring that up at the next meeting just as a topic.
Yeah, jump again.
I'll get a hold of the chamber and then.
No.
Okay.
You're not going to get
it. Thanks anyway, Jerome.
Just a question, did the chamber elect a board?
I do not know.
Staff report ready?
Yeah, so I still need to get paving done since we didn't get the grant. North Point, behind the mall, we paved a few years ago. It's like it's really bad road back there. We paved some overlay and it's very nice. It turned out good, but we only got about two-thirds of the road. We need to do the other third. I got in your packet there might be some information from gas paving for bid. So one of those is the $3,900 to finish Spencer to Vista. It'll be aprons. And also there's a lady that owns a home on the very south end of Spencer that floods every year, so we'd be able to contour the water more towards the open ditch on this stuff and then install a berm to not flood her home. So try to work with her. It's terrible. Yes.
Yeah.
And so and then the other part of the bid would be patching potholes on Vista there, including berms. There's water break patching I need to take care of. My knees will be placed at the wastewater plant entryway on South Point Street. And then the O'Connell Gallery, the sidewalk there, John Woodmark had a problem with a service line that was sawed through back when we did Bay Street by a contractor the city had hired. So we've been kind of tied into that ever since. So the repair didn't leak, but it had been shifted, the line had shifted and was touching another piece of metal, and somehow it was copper and it caused another leak from, electrical problems with
sewer.
Yeah, electrolytes also. So, anyway. John replaced the line and the plumber and did his share, and our crew had to get to shut the water off, so we actually had to get in the sidewalk, so I figured we could pave that. That's part of this patching in the city sidewalk there. So that's what the $1,775 and the $3,900 to complete Spencer. It's a total of $5,675 for patching.
Maybe on that grant, we had originally thought that we'd be able to take the overlay on Sunset, Vista Street, down
right.
Past Pirates, down past Spencer,
right.
And moving up that hill. And that kind of sounds like that's gotten going up there has been kind of kiboshed.
Yeah, well, what I'm going to do is it's in the budget also.
Right.
So what I'm going to do is I'm take care of behind Vista, right? Spencer Avenue. I'm going to do my homework and get road and driveway involved and gas paving. And that'll be probably by next meeting. I'm going to try to get that accomplished.
And so we can
that's
look
Vista, at like this pump station.
There'd be the hillside.
Right, but what, I'm talking about past the pump stations, you go up the hill.
Yeah, that's maybe, we'll have to budget that in. I think I did the intersection.
Don't we still have money in our budget for
we'll
that?
We'll see, we can review that, and maybe I could go further. Could I'll do some homework.
Could Perry look into that for us? It seems to me,
because
we made promises to a bunch of people
right.
that we were going to take and extend the overlay on Vista Street. And I'd hate for us to go back on that promise, because we publicly said we were going to do that.
And it's a terrible need.
It really is.
So North Point is terrible.
We would be done with behind the mall, and then we could come straight on Vista, and I'll see where we're at and how far I can go with Vista.
Okay. Because we promise, so we're going to keep our promises.
Yeah, absolutely.
So do you need a motion to approve?
I need the action on the 5675 because it's over.
I move that we approve and authorize Brady to proceed with that proposal for the patching in various locations for $5,800. Is that right?
Yeah, 5675, 56.
$5,700.
Yeah.
Cool.
Gambino?
Yes.
Greg?
Aye.
Teen?
Yes.
Fisher Brown?
Yes.
Olson?
Yeah.
Mathlin?
Yes.
Okay, next item. Okay. Next item, Christmas trees. We are at that point where they're going to have the lighting ceremony. Every year, for the last few years, I think the last 5 years, the city has purchased the Christmas tree. And it went on the roof of the painter building.
That's the Whale Center.
The Whale Center. And then the Whale Center is now owned by ODOT, or the state parks. So it was given back to them. So we can continue to put that. I think there was a clause in the deed back to them that they would allow the city to put a tree up on the roof. But we also, when we did Whale Fountain Park, there's a big planter box there that has a big poly pipe that's set so we can put a tree in there with a plug-in, and it's all set for a tree.
Looks
so
really nice.
Yeah, the idea was to get off the roof and put it in there, but then Daddy Taunton always liked it on the roof. So we ended up getting two trees, and at the goal was to transition just to the one in our new park. So I guess it's council's decision if we want to still continue to get two trees and do the one on the roof, because we have to round up, you know, Coast Guard and city. You know, we could do it. We do it every year. We practice for it and whatnot. We end up having bike lights, and the weather's pretty tough up there to keep the integrity of the lights going through all of December and a little bit, you know, the New Year's. So
how much money do you need for Christmas then?
It's a lot of work.
How much money do you need?
The chamber used to volunteer, but they
don't
volunteer.
Yeah. How much money do you need to get those trees? How much? $500?
The trees are about, we get it from the Thompson Street Farm in Lincoln City. They're about $8 a foot for Noble. They have large trees there. It's about $130 a tree. We get 16 footers.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to move that we authorize city staff to spend up to $500 on trees and lights to maintain the tradition down at the Whale Center.
In both places.
Yeah.
Yeah,
in
both places.
Whale Center and the park.
Okay. Second.
Single.
Can we? I see for $34.95 we can get one of those laser things that shoots stars on everything.
Yeah, I saw that the other night on TV.
Call, please.
Grant.
Aye.
Teen.
Yes.
Fisher Brown.
Yes.
Olson.
Yeah.
Mathlin.
Yes.
Gambino.
Yes.
Okay, we'll be on the roof, but the state parks works with this.
I do help out, but I don't get on ladders. I can stay on the ground and direct.
We pulled a tree in. We got a pretty good system. Okay, so we're ready for creating that something, Christmas song.
Okay, real quick, Rocky Creek, we locked in on those rights, they're perfected rights, which is pretty neat. No one can touch that with a certificate. So Rocky Creek is...
The Water Master's going to give us a certificate for that.
Yeah, protected rights, that's really great, so good job. Survey for the Raw Reservoir Dam project, the surveyor's up there, so we're moving along with that project.
Awesome.
Good.
Yeah. I have a gentleman out in Lincoln City that does cloud driving, Bill Sexton. He went up there as a courtesy just to see if his equipment would get in there. And absolutely, he could get his crane there and his cloud driver to get the platform completed. So that's good news, too, and I relayed that to the engineer. So that's about it for my report.
Yes, sir. You probably already are, but I saw it when I read that. I always read the bulletin.
Uh-huh.
Where this OWRD...
Is that the application for water supply project?
Yeah. Because I thought that would be perfect for the earth and dam and all that.
Yeah, we, well, yeah, so we there's some red tape involved in some of that.
You're aware of it. So
we, well, yeah. One time we went to the state and they said that to raise our water bills. It was a low.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Council comments. Start with Colin.
Yeah, I have one thing I wanted to bring up. I guess I actually just kind of ask for your blessing to kind of move forward and do some research. In my short time being on the council, hearing some public testimony and then talking to people in the community, and I think we could all agree, one of the subjects that people bring up quite frequently is law enforcement service. Here with the Depoe Bay. What I would ask the council if it would be okay is if I could research, gather some data, and put together some type of proposal to bring to the council to review, you know, nothing immediate for us to look at and start digesting maybe after the first of the year for possibly getting a contract law enforcement service. That proposal would be identifying funding, where it come from, possibly municipal court within the city of Depoe Bay, the benefits, pros and cons, and it could really fit timely with some other motions that are going with the city. Because obviously if we do decide to do something, it's going to take a year, 2 years down the road to actually implement something. So my thought is, well, I can start gathering some data and information and a proposal for us to start the discussion that would put us in a timeline to possibly implement something in a couple of years, a year, 2 years down the road.
I'm good.
I like that.
So I guess I just didn't want to overstep my bounds and wanted to ask you guys, so that would be where I kind of started is talking to different law enforcement agencies within the county. We don't have to contract with the sheriff's office. You know, obviously, whoever wants to give us the best price and best service would be a consideration. It would be talking to City of Toledo, City of Walport, with their municipal courts, their costs. And really just the cost and how we can structure it and different funding ideas that I have and bring that to you guys so we can talk about it. Any thoughts?
No, I'd be interested in looking at that.
Yeah. Roof? Yeah, that's great.
Thanks.
No.
Yeah, I'm going off of what you said, I would definitely be interested in looking at that. I think that short of having our own police force here in Depoe Bay, which is, may not be fiscally possible at this point, but Depoe Bay is growing, you know, little by little, and sooner or later it's going to start growing, you know, to the point where we're going to be needing facilities like that. And I especially like the idea of, you know, having law enforcement and a municipal court that would keep those funds in within the city rather than going to the county. You know, that could help us with a lot of the issues that we're dealing with in conjunction with our lack of dedication to this force. So
2 minutes after 9, I have nothing to say.
It's actually 2 minutes after 10, daylight saving.
Ah, I see.
Oh, I thought we were doing really good.
Go ahead, Robert.
I just have one thing. I sent a letter in my own behalf to waive an email to their tech support, to waive broadband. And happened to mention that I heard from some other folks within the city that were having a problem as well with their internet service. I didn't get a response back for well over 2.5 weeks. I emailed them again today and immediately got a phone call. In my email today, I said, are you going to address this issue or are you going to answer me? And they just basically pissed them off. So they called me.
And vice versa. A
gentleman named Ron, he didn't tell me his last name, but he is the technical operations supervisor for the region. And he and I talked back and forth about how it's played out timeline-wise, because I had two techs out at my house. One said the problem is across the street in the trunking, so I have to send a different tech out. That tech came out, was a little higher up tech, and he said, no, it's not. It's part of this major problem we're having in town. This was many, many, many months ago. In fact, it was in August or earlier July. And he said, we're working on it. We can't find the problem. I reported this before to the council. Anyway, this guy, Ron, really didn't know too much about that. So he said, basically, now he's going to light a fire. And he's going to get some things done.
Cool.
And he'll be probably calling me back.
There's multiple locates that came in from three different boring companies, all working for Wave Cable, Little Oco, some in North, some up in Hoffman Shoal. So something happened within the last week.
Yeah, but it's still slow. I mean, it's still, the problem we're noticing and other people that we've talked to is that it slows down and then goes back up to speed. Slows down. Sometimes it'll be out for 5 or 10 minutes.
Wasting a lot of stuff. So.
Yeah, he said they've spent $1 million so far on cable just in this greater area. But he's going to step it up.
Good job, Robert. Okay. My turn?
Your turn.
Okay, you know, we almost didn't make it, Mayor. I've got, 5 seconds because I'm going to allow the 5 minutes overtime, but I'm going to give you first prize, okay, for getting us out by 9 o'clock, we'll just say. First prize. And I'm just going to get a picture of me and you.
First prize.
Is that what you did the whole city council meeting?
I just did. He was good after watching the office.
Oh, yeah, he does.
You going to eat?
He's good.
Well, I wish I would have had a blue pen, I would.
So that's fine. And the camera.
Very nice. Job.
Nice to meet you.
There's the ribbon.
Yeah.
I'm honored, Jerome. Thank you. That'll go.
That's pretty cool.
Take that over, kids, go and hang up.
Yeah, there you go.
That it, kids?
That's it.
Yes. Well, it's 6 minutes after 10, daylight savings time.